Hey guys, I found this old script. It's ripped a little bit. Fugitive, Harrison Ford. I think we can use some of this. What's going on, everybody? Jared here with another action movie review. But if you're new to this channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button because it seriously helps me out and it keeps you guys up to date on this channel's newest content every single week. So I went out and saw the third installment. Yeah, third installment in the Gerard Butler Has Fallen trilogy, Angel Has Fallen. Mike Banion is up for FBI director until he is framed for an attack on the president. On the run, Mike has to be careful who he trusts, whether it's friends or family. So does Angel Has Fallen prove this Gerard Butler trilogy a win? Let's find out. But before I get into my thoughts, let me know what you guys thought of this oddly reminiscent, familiar 90s movie in the comments down below. Now let's get into some of the good. I mean, this follow-up to Olympus and London Has Fallen is exactly what you think it would be. It's Gerard Butler kicking some ass, saving the day, there's action, there's explosions. That's essentially what this Has Fallen trilogy has been, so there's not much new here. So the caliber of action and explosions, and I mean a lot of explosions, there was explosions on explosions, people flying every which way from these explosions, which is odd to say that one of the film's positives is explosions. All right, who wrote one whole page of explosions? Chad? Perfect. But very closely related to these explosions was a guest spot from a character, Nick Nolte. He, you know, obviously they tried to add in this father-son angle into the movie. They don't go too deep into it, but he was a very nice added addition to this movie because he is this cranky old war veteran living in the hills, living off of the land. He's a mountain man, but it is fantastic. He is by far one of the standouts, and again, him and explosions go together perfectly. And it's also odd to say because he does not have much screen time at all. I would say maybe 10 minutes at tops. So yeah, the two positives of this film of Angel Has Fallen are Nick Nolte and explosions. Put that on the poster. But yeah, Angel Has Fallen, like I mentioned earlier, it's exactly what you think it would be. And the through line, the plot is very predictable. It's familiar. You've seen this before. I mean, it's oddly It's oddly reminiscent of lots of movies we've seen. I mean, specifically 90s action movies. Fugitive. Oh, man. Allergies, man. So, yeah, unfortunately, any twist and turn that is put into this movie, you know exactly where it's gonna lead. Evil character one shows up, and you know damn well that it's gonna be revealed that he is officially evil character number one later on in the movie. Alright, we're sticking with Angel Has Fallen, even though he's not saving the Pope. Hell, even whole set pieces felt like they were from the wrong decade, like this big baddie rooftop battle or an intense truck chase scene, which, oh my gosh, hold on. Logic. Logic is completely thrown out the window in this movie. There is zero logic. Characters are doing things. They're motivated for no apparent reason. For example, Gerard Butler steals an 18-wheeler to outrun cops, or the president completely, I guess, pardons someone without getting any sort of evidence for them. All of the evidence is against them. And the overall plan for the baddies, breaking it down, looking into their plan, I have no idea what their end game was. I don't know what they were trying to do. It didn't make any sense. Obviously, the movie takes them certain ways, but if they almost should have done this in a legal sense rather than illegally and maliciously, because I don't know where it was leading. Do you think we need to clear up the bad guy motives a little bit? No? No one's gonna care? Sounds good. It's just a big, dumb, turn-your-brain-off popcorn summer flick, which brings me to my last point. Like I mentioned earlier, the action, the explosions, that was great. But the way that the action, specifically the fight scenes, the car chases, the way it was framed and shot felt very sloppy. It was close in angles, it was jump cutty, it was shaky cam. A lot of the scenes, I couldn't tell, you know, who was throwing a punch, who was getting shot. And luckily, it's not a lot of the movie, but the action scenes, that's what, you know, these three movies in this franchise are known for. It's hard to see exactly what's going on. So this sloppy framing, shooting, it's not good. Overall, Angel Has Fallen should have listened to Life Alert and not gotten up. With an explosive, pun intended, performance from Nolte, but with zero logic, it being very familiar and some sloppy action scenes. I'd skip out or maybe wait for rental. If you're a big fan of this Has Fallen trilogy, you're a Has Fallen purist, wait, go out, see it, I don't know. Otherwise, I mean, you've seen this movie before. It's very reminiscent of any 90s movie. In closing, I'm gonna give Angel Has Fallen 2 out of 5 cliched plots. So what did you guys think of Angel Has Fallen? I wanna know in the comments down below. Anyways, guys, as always, thank you so much for watching. Watch some more videos up there, you know, movie reviews, trailer reactions, fun comedy skits. I think tomorrow or the day after, there's gonna be a review for Peter Butter Falcon. And then on Monday, I think episode 2 of Movies and Nonsense will post, so stay tuned for that. Follow all of my social media down there. Click that subscribe button. It seriously helps me out. And until next time, I'll see you later.